Hello my dear students, welcome for the online classes. Today we will continue with the same lesson. The topic which we are going to study today is how nomads and mobile people lived. Nomadic pastoralites moved over the long distances with their animals. They lived on milk and other pastoral products. They also exchanged wool, ghee, etc. with the settled agriculturalist for grain, cloth, utensils and other products. They bought and sold these goods as they moved from one place to another, transporting them on their animals. Now children, nomadic pastoralites. Who were nomadic pastoralites? Nomadic pastoralists were the people who traveled from place to place with their animal in search of better pastures. Their movement mainly depend upon the season. According to the season, they move from one place to another. In Maharashtra, these nomadic people had migrated to drier regions because their animals could not live in the rainy season. They lived on milk and other products. They exchanged the ghee, whatever were the animal products, they exchanged ghee and wool with the settled agriculturalist for the grains, clothes, utensils and the other products. Means whatever the goods which they gain from the animals, they exchange to earn their livelihood. Sometimes they even left their animals in the fields to obtain the better fertility by the natural methods. Now children, let us see the next paragraph. The Banjaras were the most important trader nomads. Their caravan was called the Tenda. Sultan Aladdin Khilji, that which we have studied about him in chapter number 3, used the Banjaras to transport the grain to the city markets. Now, Banjaras were the people who moved with their animals. And that time, Emperor Jahangir wrote in his memoirs that the Banjaras carried grain on their bullocks from different areas and sold it in towns. Now again they transported the food grains for the Mughal army during the military campaigns. The rulers who were ruling that time, the rulers who were ruling this time, they tried to get the products from the tribal peoples in this way. With the large army, there could be 1 lakh bullocks carrying the grains. Now children, Banjaras were, as we it is said that Banjaras were mostly the trader nomads. Their caravans were known as Tenda, and they were employed by the Delhi Sultans. That time Delhi Sultans were ruling in these areas, and the Banjaras carried the grains on their bullocks and brought them to the city market. So this was done by the Banjara people. And also children, many pastoral tribes also sold the animals like cattle and horses. Many other people also traveled from place to place to sell their wares, such as ropes, straw mattings, matting, etc. Entertainers and mendicants also went from place to place. Now also children, during this period the entire society underwent the social changes. Some of the tribal societies were incorporated in the Hindu society. That time the people were incorporated with the Hindu society. Some new Rajput clans became powerful, like Hunas, Chandelas and Chalukyas. Now you have heard these words in the chapter number 3. Some joined lower caste and some of them joined the lower caste. Some of the powerful tribes during this period were some of the powerful tribes of Punjab, Sindh and Northwest adopted the Islam, and they also rejected the caste system. The emergence and these led to the emergence of the state is closely related, and this emergence of the state is closely related to the social change among the tribal people. This is how the nomad and the mobile people lived during this period. Now children, in your textbook about the Banjaras, it is given that Peter Mundy, an English trader who came to India during the early 17th century, has described the Banjaras. He has written about the life of the Banjaras, how the Banjaras spend their life. So it is, in short, it is given, let us take a glance. In the morning, we met a tenda of Banjara, means he has shared his experience, and he has given that in the morning we met a tenda of Banjaras with 14,000 oxen. They were laden with the grain such as wheat and rice. They carry their households, wives and children along with them. Whatever was their family, they used to carry with them, the animals, the family along with them. One tenda consists of many families. They are hired by the merchants, and they also buy grains themselves and carry it to the distant places. In a tenda, there may be as many 600 to 700 people. They travel not more than 6 to 7 miles a day, and after unloading the oxen, they are left to graze. So this was the routine of the Banjara people, how they led their life. So in short, Peter Mundy, an English trader, has given the brief account how the Banjaras spend their life. So children, this is about the concept about the life of the nomads. Now let us move towards the, in your textbook, a closer look is given about the Gonds and the Ahoms. These are the two tribes which is given in your textbook. Just it is the case study how these people have spent their life. And also children, one thing it is mentioned in your textbook that the changing society, the new caste and the hierarchy. During this people, during this period, the entire society underwent the social changes. I have explained you this point. As the economy and the need of the society grew, people with the new skills were required. Smaller caste or the jatis emerged with the varnas. And for example, the new caste appeared amongst the brahmanas. And on other hand, many tribe and the social groups were taken into the caste-based society and given the status of jatis. And this way, we had the different groups of people, and so the caste system which we see in the society was done, the caste discrimination which was done, and the people were treated according to their caste was after this. Children, it is given about the Rajputs also, that the rise of the Rajput clan to the position of the ruler set an example for the tribal people to follow. So just go through this point and read these points thoroughly, and you will understand that how the entire society underwent the social changes, and how the people, how the some of the tribes joined the another groups. Now the last point which is given is the closer look, the Gonds and the Ahoms. Let us see in short who were the Gonds. The Gonds were the people of central India. They lived in the forested area called Gondwana, or country inhabited by the Gonds. The Gonds were traditionally agriculturalists. Some practiced shifting cultivation, while others raised the cereals or herded cattle. And the Gond society was highly stratified. And Gondwala, or the land of the Gonds, is a loosely defined area of southeastern Madhya Pradesh, eastern Maharashtra, and the parts of Chhattisgarh, Orissa, and northern Andhra Pradesh. Then again, children, more information is given about the Gonds. That is the large Gond tribe was divided into the smaller clan, and each clan has its own ruler. In about the 15th century, the large kingdom started dominating the smaller ones. And Akbarnama mentions, Akbar, we have studied about the Akbarnama, and Akbarnama mentions one of the Gond kingdom of the Graha Katanga. And the emergence of the large states changed the social fabric, which now came to be divided into unequal societies. The Gonds Raja wanted the recognition as the Rajput and gave the large grant of land to the Brahmanas. One of the rulers of Grahakatanga, Amandas, took the title of Sangram Shah, and his son Dalpat married a Rajput princess Durgavati, the daughter of the Chandela Rajput ruler. Now children, in 1565, the Mughal armies attacked the Grahakatanga, and Rani Durgavati, who was ruling in the name of her minor son, put a tough resistance, and she was defeated and preferred death. Her son also died in fighting. Then, how was the administration, children? The administration has become highly centralized, with all the powers in hand of the ruler. The kingdom was divided into Graha, and each Graha controlled a particular clan. Graha was again divided into the groups of 84 villages called Chaurasi, and the Chaurasi was divided into Barhots consisting of 12 villages each. Then children, Grahakatanga was a rich state. It has earned a huge amount of wealth by trapping and selling the wild elephants to the other kingdoms. The Mughals defeated the Gonds and carried away a large booty. Later, this state struggled against Bundelas and the Marathas. So, this is about the Gonds. And the last one which is given is the Ahoms. Let us see who were the Ahoms. The Ahoms established their kingdom in the part of present-day Assam. This regime in the ancient historical literature is mentioned as a Kamrup. Children, in the 13th century, a prince from China began his journey with about 9,000 followers, crossed the Patkai Hills and reached the Brahmaputra Valley. And there they established their capital at Charyadyo near Sipsagar. Then they expanded their territories at the cost of Chutia Kingdom and Koch Ahoj. And also children, Ahoms built a large state and used the firearms, gunpowder and canoes in the warfare. By the middle of the 16th century, the Ahoms controlled the eastern Assam also. Now again, the Mughals in 1662 attacked the Ahom kingdom and defeated it. However, the Mughals' control could not last longer. The Ahom state depended upon the forced labor. Forced labor, the census of the population was taken, and those who worked for the state were called the paiks. Each village had to send the number of the paiks by rotation, and all the adults or males had to serve in the army during the war. Otherwise, they were engaged in building dams and the other public works. The people from the thickly populated area were sent to the less populated areas. Again, children, the Ahom society was divided into khels, and each khel controlled the several villages. You will just read these paragraphs very thoroughly. So children, at last we come to the conclusion that the considerable social change took place in the subcontinent during the period and which we have been examining. And the Varna-based society and the tribal people constantly interacted with each other. And some tribes were incorporated into the Brahminical fold, while some tribes established the strong administration and clashed with the Mughals. So children, this is about the tribes, about the Ahoms. And also children, the last, finally it is mentioned that some tribes established the extensive states, some tribes established the extensive states with well-organized systems of administration, and thus they become politically powerful, and this brought them into the conflict with the larger and more complex kingdom and empire. Thank you.